Praise the Lord, mighty prophet of the Lord.
Amen, Pastor Michael. Now listen, the Lord has been speaking with me from yesterday. The Lord, He has spoken with me, and I've written them down here. It's quite a few conversations, and I'll go through them one by one. Yesterday, again, this is about Kenya. Yesterday, the first conversation, yesterday, Friday, November 8th, 2013, the first conversation, and in that conversation, I'm describing this now, it was in the afternoon while writing the oracle of the Lord, and the Lord slayed me, and this is what the Lord spoke about. Immediately showed me a great, great, humongous healing that is coming to Kenya. He showed me a healing, very big healing, that is going to visit this land. Again, the Lord showed me yesterday afternoon, November 8th, 2013. In the afternoon, while in the office writing the articles, the oracles of the Lord, when He slayed me and I fell asleep, this is what I saw: a great healing that is coming to this land. Number two, when I woke up, then again He slayed me, and then He showed me a great, great, great harvesting of souls, a humongous revival that is coming to Kenya. Much, much bigger than what you have seen today. Very great, for record revival, tremendous record number of souls harvested. And the harvesting was continuing. I was involved in it. The Lord showed me in that dream. Again, the second part of the conversation, I repeat, a great, unequaled level of revival. I call it here the greatest revival of all time that is coming to Kenya. And I saw the unbelievable harvesting of souls, the humongous heap. The Lord showed me from a distance the number of souls, very, very record number of souls harvested for Christ. And then after that, the third conversation that afternoon yesterday, I'm still on November 8th, when the Lord showed me the tremendous flow of the river of the Holy Spirit that will come and flow over this land. And I described the following here. One, the water was very, very clear water. Number two, I could see, it was so clear that I could see the little white stones at the bottom of the river. Number three, it was crystal clear. And so I see a tremendous river, the river of the Holy Spirit that is coming to flow over this land. And then yesterday night, now that is 9th November this day, but in the night of yesterday, 2013 at night, I want to share the following two conversations major. Then the Lord finally showed me the mightiest river of the Holy Spirit that I have ever seen since He called me. Now this is a bigger river, the most humongous river, the river that was coming with great force, with crystal clear water, and it was flowing in one direction in major, major force. The river of the Holy Spirit that is coming to flow in this land like never ever seen before. Now this becomes a repeat of the conversation of Friday 8th November 2013 yesterday afternoon, when the Lord showed me the great river of the Holy Spirit that would flow in this land. Very clear water. I could see the white stones at the bottom of the river. Crystal clear waters, like glass, so I could see through. But then in the night, the Lord showed me a huge river, the biggest river of the Holy Spirit I have ever seen. The second most important conversation in the night, November 9, 2013. Then the Lord showed me the biggest healing that will ever take place on the planet Earth. The biggest we have ever seen. The unparalleled healing I have not seen on that level that is coming to this ministry, that is coming to this nation of Kenya. And so I want to summarize this conversation as follows. That the big awakening that began the day yesterday, when people began to be awakened to the fact that lest this man abuses the grace of God that is apportioned to her, that lest this nation abuses the humongous historic latter glory of the Lord that has visited here, lest this nation loses the humongous historic glory, the visitation of Jehovah Elohim himself, when the cloud lifts. And I say it very clearly that Israel has not had this opportunity. They did not have the opportunity to cross-check themselves, to take a spiritual inventory on how far they have walked with the Father. And that's why this awakening is very critical. It became very, very critical. I can see that in the reflection of the conversation that the Lord has had with me. And that in this conversation with the Lord, I can see that this nation will continue to enjoy the favor of the Lord, owing to the awakening of the 3 days of repentance, national repentance and fasting. And I want to underscore here that this is the only nation on the earth that does this kind of thing, that takes 3 days of prayer and fasting and repenting. And all churches, people are in churches today. I mean, this is absolutely historic. This is absolutely very historic and very unique to this country. And I'm indeed very blessed, because I thought to myself, if this nation will lose the glory this late in the day, doesn't it mean that the rest of the doors you can fit in, you can complete for yourself? Again, I repeat, I began to fear for this land, that if this land will lose the glory in the complacency of their hearts, in the familiarity with God, with the servant of the Lord too, doesn't it mean that it will be too late for them to ever receive another revival? And that's why today I'm very blessed to announce to you that Jehovah, the God of heaven, my master and my sender, my God and my Lord, He has spoken with me favorably and beautifully about this country. The biggest revival that has not even been written is coming to this land. And many, 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 many more millions of souls are going to find Christ Jesus the Messiah. And in this ministry, I am asking the pastors to prepare the tents, because there is going to be an unparalleled and unequaled harvesting of souls and overflow in the temple, the house of the Lord. And I'm also encouraging you to continue in repentance, except for 2 ministries the Lord showed me, which I'm going to address eventually at the end of this session of repentance and fasting. There are 2 ministries that are so struggling. They are going in the opposite direction of the current of this humongous, historic, and equal river of Jehovah. I saw them trying, and the wave hit them, they hit the rocks at the side, and it was deadly. I'll describe that particularly when I get a chance to meet with them in front of the Council of Bishops. But most importantly, there is going to be an unbelievable visitation of God the Father. He has shown His disposition of love, disposition of grace upon grace. This grace upon grace is huge grace. It's grace that has not visited another land, another nation. And that is owing to the fact that in this place, the gospel has now attained its purpose in the life of those who subscribe to the ministry of repentance and holiness, and the King's Outreach Churches, and the Altar Restoration Churches. Only those I am talking about at this hour. That there's going to be tremendous visitation to those who have subscribed to the ministry of repentance and holiness. And I talked about the King's Outreach Churches, and also the Altar Restoration Churches. All the other churches, the doors are open. As long as they subscribe to repentance and holiness and the turning away from sins, this is the hour to experience the historic revival that was foretold in the Bible. There is no other hour. Everybody else is welcome to this revival, but I have talked about what the Lord has shown me and spoken by voice regarding the people that are preparing for the coming of the Messiah. And again, I want to repeat here very clearly, in the afternoon yesterday, the tremendous healing is coming, but you see that later in the night, he now shows me a record healing that surpasses that almost a billion fold. When I thought in the afternoon that was a record healing we have not seen, then now in the night he shows me tremendous historic healing that is coming to this ministry, the ministry of repentance and holiness, and those that subscribe to repentance and the return to holiness. And I have also seen the two rivers. That is tremendous. The Lord repeated the same thing. He talks two times about them. The river that I saw in the day, in the afternoon yesterday, and then in the night, the humongous river that nobody, and I repeat, nobody, can ever resist, can ever stand against, can ever go in the direction opposite their current. They would be doing so at their own peril at this hour. And then the Lord also showed me, and the other churches that have not subscribed, I saw the fish that was killed in the other churches. And the second thing, he also spoke to me about people that are going to hell. That was my voice, even in the presence of the office team that were able to write these things down. And again, I saw people that are going to hell still and from church. And that tells us that we still have a lot of work to do to reach as many people who are unborn again, including those that so-called, so say they are born again in the other churches and yet have not yet submitted to the holiness of the Lord. The Bible is clear in the inscriptions that it eloquently projects to us, and it says very clearly that for without holiness, nobody will ever see the Lord. So this becomes yet another window for us to get back to the vineyard. And so based on all these conversations between yesterday and this day, I want to say the following, that keep on loving the Lord as a nation, keep on loving righteousness, that the Lord may continue speaking with me about his disposition of love over this land. These are the days when it is a wonderful thing to receive from the Lord such a glorious message on the disposition of love that the Lord has over a nation. The journey is long. I have many nations. I'm yet to fight for the Lord that all of them will receive the same level of conversation of the disposition of love towards them. Remember, he died for all nations, not only Kenya. But I know that Kenya becomes the seat of his servants, and that's why the tremendous disposition of love, the historic, the unequal, the unparalleled. However, this door is open to all nations, all churches, and I can say in finishing the following, that because of that, then the prayer and fasting and repentance that began yesterday will be completed tomorrow at sunset. And beginning tomorrow at sunset, there shall be no wailing in this land. There shall be no mourning in this land. The awakening has reached the ears of the Lord. At this hour tomorrow by this time, you will have entered into a new dispensation, a dispensation of the revival, the coveted and the fearful revival that the Bible says would come in these days. Continue loving the Lord. Continue breaking before him, breaking down before him. Continue in the humility of your heart, because the reward is unequaled at the end of this road. May the Lord bless you, for the Messiah is coming. And for the nations that have heard me speak these words of love to Kenya, This is what the Lord says to you. The journey is long, and I am still on the road, and the Holy Spirit is on this journey. And that if any nation will be able to turn to the Lord in repentance and holiness, He shall do with them even as He has done with Kenya. And at this hour, in finishing, I say, has the Lord spoken with this land of Kenya? Shalom.